Hello and welcome back to the channel. So in today's video we are going to be doing some snow bases. So these are in a way quite like the bases we've done in previous videos, except this time it's going to have more of an Arctic tundra type feel. So what we're going to do first of all, just going to run over a few bits that we're going to need. So we are obviously you're going to need your base, so you're going to have to start off with a square base, circle base, whatever base you're using for your miniatures, whatever you choose really. You start off with that. Again, we shall be using things like our generic sand pot. So again, if you haven't seen my other basing tutorials yet, this is just my little tub full of generic sand. So this is actually made of bird gravel, the kind of stuff you get in, Wilkinson's pet supply stores, the kind of thing your budgie will go, stick his feet in and rub around and what have you. What I do with my bases though, I tend to run this mix through a little bit of a fine sieve. Just the kind of one you'd use for, sugar, flour, the kind of one you get for your kitchen. I just run that through there just to get out the big lumps and stuff like this. So when you put your base in the model, put the sand on the base, you're not going to end up with big clumps of stones and stuff where you don't really want them. So we start off with that first of all. There we go. We are also going to be using again some of this. So if you haven't seen my videos again, this is basically little tiny chips of plaster. So these are little tiny chunks that look like rocks. They're perfect to use for little stones, little rocks, some debris, broken bits of pavement, things like that. And again, the keen-eyed among you would notice this is actually cat litter. So what with me having a cat, I've just basically gone, got a handful out of the cat litter bag, stuck it into a pot, sorted. You can even run this through like a sieve that you use in your garden for rocks and things, just to get different sized ones if you want to really sort them out. So you've got large, small, and medium. This is so cheap, it's unbelievable. You can use slate as well if you wish, but for this video, I will be using this. This is sold in Tesco's, so this is the cat litter basically that we buy for our cat, and we've got bags and bags of the stuff, but a whole tub of that will last you pretty much, I'd say, at least a good few years if you're using that just as rocks. The other thing we'll need, obviously, the most important part, some PVA glue. So this is just generic PVA glue. Think I bought this from a craft store for a couple of quid. Dirt cheap. Really easy to use. The first thing you do, obviously, you stick your rocks down, the little plaster chips. What I do is I tend to stick them down with super glue, so I just use your generic Loctite. You can use any super glue you want. Just make sure, obviously, before you put the PVA glue down on the base, that the actual base, well, the actual stones have glued down and the super glue has set. Otherwise, you're just going to end up with super glue on the end of your brush, and it's not fun. Once you put the PVA down and put your sand on, you'll end up with this. So this is just generic little base. It's got sand on it. It's got a couple of rocks. It's this is exactly what you want. So when it's drying, obviously you just run your fingers around the edge just to get a nice smooth edge. You can do this on circle bases, square. I'm just using square bases for this, just for purely demonstrational purposes, as I had a few of these ones spare, and these aren't the slotted ones, so that was perfect. Once we've done this, we then prime the base with black. So here's one I did earlier. This is just your normal black, chaos black, matte black from Army Paint, Vallejo black, any type of black you want to use, spray paint. Obviously, if you're doing about 30 or 40 of these at a time, what I'd suggest doing is just double-sided tape on a piece of board or cardboard, stick them all down, just blast the whole thing with super glue. Super glue, I mean black spray paint. You want to put super glue on them. Just cheap old one. You don't go buying, the 7 or 8 quid Army Painter or 7 or 8 quid Games Workshop one. Just go to places like Poundland, pick up their auto spray paint they have. They usually have Silver Wheel is called, grey primer or matte black or gloss black. Pick up the matte black. It's a quid. You're not going to worry about using the whole can on like 40 or 50 of these. I've got about 10 or 11 of those cans of spray paint just because they're so much, they're really, really handy to have around. For displays, you don't want to spend 20 quid when you can spend 2 quid. That's pretty much it. So once you've got this, We then start with our first little part, which is going to be our first paint, and that's going to be this Mechanicus Standard Grey. So I'm going to be doing kind of a grey style base for the snow, just so it doesn't take too much look, like too much of the effect off the base. So what I'm going to do now, I'm just going to pop some on my brush like this, and what I'm going to do, I'm just going to get some of it off onto my palette. So this isn't the dry brush and this isn't a full loaded brush, it's basically, it's like a heavy dry brush, that's what I'm going to call it. And what we're going to do, we're just going to go over the whole thing, just like that. And what this is going to do, a nice heavy dry brush, it's just going to add a nice little base layer to the model. Just like that. There we go. Easy as that. So that's your first layer done. So I'll keep that paint there. The next layer, what we're going to do is we are going to be using this. So this is Administratum Grey. So this is just a lighter version of that. See? But obviously what we're going to be doing, because this is a snow theme base, we are going to be working up to a lighter colour. So what we're going to do, we're going to take our brush again. I haven't even bothered washing this off because there's no point. You know, I'm just going to get a bit onto my brush. Again, I'm going to stick this onto my palette. But this time we're going to do a bit of a lighter kind of dry brush. So it's not as heavy as the last one, but we still want to get a decent bit of that colour on. So we're just going to drag the brush over quite, not heavy and not lightly, just enough so where we can start seeing the paint starting to show. So you'll mainly see it on the rocks and all the little bits of gravel that you want to pop out. There we go. Bring my lamp up a little tiny bit. There we go. So you make sure you get all around by the rocks. And there you go, it's all fully applied. So this probably is one of the quickest basing tutorials that you can do. You know, you can have these bases done in a matter of minutes. You can do 20 or 30 of these in probably about half an hour once everything's dry. That's the beauty of these, is they are so simple to do snow bases. So that's where we are at the moment. So you can see obviously that light grey that we used, the Administratum, that has essentially now made every single little bit of the grain pop and also the rocks. So the final stage we're going to do on the paint wise side of things is we're going to take some of this. So this is matte white, and I'm specifically using matte white because I don't want to have a shiny finish and I don't want it to look too shiny. This is a really, really nice paint to use. It's got good coverage, you know, and it also dry brushes incredibly well. So what we're going to do, we're going to load a little bit onto our brush. This is going to be one of those dry brushes where it's extremely, extremely light. So what we're going to do, we're just going to drag it across just to pick out some of the detail. So you'll mainly see all this detail start to pop on things like the rocks, you know. Change my brush over quickly. So I'm still using a normal makeup brush. Just going to get some of that off onto my brush line, and then we're just going to drag it over. So what this is going to do, as you can see there, I've just done half of the base. You can see the contrast between the two. You can see that side's a lot darker, that side's a lot lighter, and it's made the rock a lot more highlighted as well. But that's the reason why we do this color. This is basically the final stage of the color. So you have all the colors underneath showing through. You just give it a nice dry brush all over. Make sure you're getting all around the edges, all around the corners. Don't want to miss any spots. Flip the model or the base round. You can do this while your models are attached. Obviously, I myself, just mainly as a preference, I prefer to do this when my models are off the bases. So what I do is I build my models and I mount them to temporary bases. Usually they're just a bag. I've got a bag of scrappy bases that I've got that I've had for years. They're absolutely thick with paint. I just super glue the model lightly down to the top of it. I use it for undercoat and paint the model on. Once the model's painted, I'll then snap it. It will come off and I'll just super glue it or pin it to their new base. So the next part of this tutorial is going to be obviously probably the most important part. What with this being a snow base, we're going to use some snow texture. So this is technical paint from Games Workshop called Valhalla Blizzard. You can also use this if you want to, which is the Vallejo's environmental paint. So this is again just the snow, but you can see the size comparison of what you get compared to the Games Workshop one. So if I can read that correctly, the Games Workshop one is, doesn't help that everything is white, 24 milliliters in this one, whereas the Vallejo one is 40 milliliters, and this is about a quid cheaper. This is a really, really nice technical paint to use. Just open it up. You can see it is quite a thick paste, but for this tutorial, obviously, I think more people will have access to the Games Workshop stuff, so I shall be using the Games Workshop stuff. So what I'm going to do, I'm just going to give this a quick shake, just so we can get some into the lid, just like that. And what I tend to do is I tend to get just a scalpel, a blade, you know, a spreading tool, anything you've got that's flat and thin enough. I just take some onto the knife, you know, the spreading tool, and I will just apply it to the base. So there's no set pattern of how I'm going to do it. There's no real reason as to why I'm putting this here and why I'm putting that there. It's purely just because I want it to be put there. It's just to make it as random as you can. You can even put a little tiny bit of the snow on top of the rocks if you want. And just spread that out on the rocks, make it look like it's been snowing on top of those as well. Just like that. And what we're going to do, we're going to cover as much or as little of the base as you want, really. You know, I tend to put about, I'd say 3/4 of the base is going to be snow. Just leave it a little bit of the grey showing through. So we're just spreading it out all over the base. And this is obviously how I do pretty much my snow bases on my models. There's no right or wrong way to do this. You can do this however you feel, you know. If you want to put less snow on, put less snow on. If you want to do it just in certain areas, do it. You know, there's no way you can or can't do these. I'm just showing you the techniques of how I go about doing my bases. So I'm just going to put a little bit on top of this rock here. Just need to get a little bit more out. The reason why I tend to use a scalpel for this is just because it's a little bit more precise than using the spreading tool, and I can work it a little bit better. There we go, just put a little bit of snow in the corner there. And obviously the good thing about these as well, these bases, is if you did the exact same thing we did earlier, minus the snow, you've got some perfect dungeon bases, you know. It's going to be a really good way of doing Moria goblins, you know, all that kind of stuff. Anything that requires a grey base. But what I'm going to do now is I'm just going to go around and I'm just going to smooth out all the edges. Because when you do this, it basically makes it look as if it's kind of like semi-melted and a little less globbed on. Pop a little bit more in the middle there. Smooth that out. There we go. So there's your snow all added onto the base. Plop that there. Obviously, you just give your scalpel a bit of a wash, just dip it into some water, and that stuff just washes off straight away. There is another little step that you can do if you wish. And you can do this, which is add some little static grass tufts. So these are the army painter ones, and these are called frozen tuft. So these are the kind of ones you'd use on, your Arctic tundra style bases and things like that. Obviously, there are other brands like the ones we've used in our previous videos. So you've got places like Gamergrass. They do the same kind of bases like tufts as these. The only reason why I have these is because I have these on some previous models and I want to use the same brand. But as you can see, the price difference in them, £1.50, that extra £1.50, that's a paint. But I'm not going to knock these because I've used these in the past and these come very well organized in different sizes. So you've got small, you've got your mediums, and you've got your very large tufts just there. So I'm going to crack this open. This is actually a brand new packet, so it's going to be perfect for this. Then what we're going to do, obviously these come on these little sheets, we're going to pick the tufts that we want. So I'm just going to go with a couple of small little tufts. I'll use my tweezers for this because I don't want to get all snow over my fingers. And then what I'm going to do, I'm just going to pick up a couple of little spots, so mainly by the rocks, and I'm just going to add a couple of little tufts just by those rocks. Now these kind of static grass tufts, you can get these in other shops, you can get them in different brands, you can get them kind of anywhere you really want to. But you can even, well, you can even do these yourself if you really fancy the need to. But me personally, I just find it easier just to buy a couple of little tufts and stick them down. But there you go. So there's a couple of little tufts added to the base. And they do just add that nice little 3D element. The kind of, it just adds a little bit more variety to the bases so they don't all look like just generic sand and rock. And you do get quite a lot in the packs as well. You can't really knock it for that kind of price, but I just thought I'd use the ones that I've always been using, so we've gone for that. Now the next stage is probably one of the easiest bits. This is just where we neaten up the base because obviously we've been doing dry brushing and things like that. You can see there all along the edge, it's all grey. So what we're going to do, just going to get some black paint. This is just your normal matte black paint from Army Painter. There we go, I'll just pop that there. And we're just going to go round the edge and we're just going to neaten up with some black paint. Now you can do this in any color you want. You can do white, you can do gray, you can do, I don't know, any kind of color you want. Dark gray, light gray, you can do it red if you already felt the need to. But me personally, I just go with a standard black because it looks neat and tidy. And that's pretty much how I always do my models anyway. So obviously just being a little bit careful. Normally you do this when the models or the base is really, really dry. Just gonna go around. Paint the edges. Now I think this is one of probably the quickest tutorials, but mainly because there is a lot less steps and it is a lot easier to do. And with that, that's your base done. So as I said, you can do this for individual models. If you're playing a D&D game, if you're doing something like Dungeon Quest, or you just want a hero model, or you just fancy a little bit of fun, you can use it for them. You can then, do 20 or 30 of these at a time. You can do whatever tickles your fancy. I use these exact same techniques on a model I've just done. So this is a Primaris Blood Angel I've just done. Instead of using the little cat litter chunks, I've just used chunks of slate instead, super glued them to the base. Done the exact same methods for the base, except I've just added some little icicles made from melted bits of flying sand. But I'll get to that in a later tutorial. But again, the same principles apply. You put that on, and that's pretty much you're good to go. You can, if you need to, or if you really, really want to, you can do a little bit of an extra stage, which I'll show you now. You can use some gloss varnish. So this is just the Army Painter gloss varnish. It's nothing swanky, nothing spectacular. What you can do is you can then get a brush, any old brush will do, load it up, and then you can just put some gloss varnish just round the edges of stuff, just to make it look a little bit like a little bit of frozen ice. So just round the edges of the snow, around the edges of the bases, on top of the rocks. Any bits that don't really have snow on them, I tend to do just round the sides. Pick this up and show you. So as you can see at the back there, I'm just going to put little blobs around there. And then obviously when this dries, this will give you a nice little bit of gloss shine. And it will either look like, you know, it can look like melted snow, it can look like ice. It just adds that another little level of extraness to the base, you know. So it's not just snow. But obviously putting it around the edges of the snow, it makes it look like the snow's melted. And also with it being gloss varnish, it will harden quite nicely and it will protect your base as well, which is also another little benefit. And there you go, with that, there's the extra step done. So that's obviously a little bit of an optional extra. I personally do tend to do that on my ice bases, just because it makes it look like, you know, fresh snowfall or melted ice, that type of thing. Let me pick it up and give you a closer look. So as you can see there, it's got a nice little shine to it when the camera focuses. There we go. You can see there, it's got a nice little shine. Just makes it look a little bit more frozen and a little bit more like ice. So if you did do this in like big batch painting of 20 or 30, you just go around and do that stage all in one. But with that, I'm going to call it done. And that's how you do your bases. So we'll just run over the processes one more time. So you start with your base, your blank base, your primer black. You then use Mechanica standard grey. You do a heavy dry brush on top of the black paint with that. Once that's dry, you move over to administratum grey. You do a heavy-ish dry brush. Once that's dry, you do a light dry brush of the matte white. This is what will basically bring out all your detail. Once that's all dry, you then get your spatula or application tool, craft knife, anything you want. You apply your Valhalla Blizzard or your equivalent snow mixture onto the base. Once that's done, you then have the optional choice of applying the gloss varnish. This can be used to make the melted snow appearance, you know, ice, that kind of thing. And then you just rim the base with the matte black. So, I hope you all found this very interesting. Obviously, there is a lot of these tutorials out on the internet, but I'm hoping that my way has given you another little alternative that's not going to break your balance or your bank. You know, it's not going to be crazy. Say, the brushes that I was using for this, this is a makeup brush. These come in packs of 20, you know, all different sizes, dirt cheap. The brush that I use to ruin the bases, it's just a generic paintbrush from a craft set. All the kind of stuff you can pick up in your high street stores. You know, it's not going to cost you 20 or 30 quid for one brush. And if you mess up or, you know, you get super glue on it, you're not going to worry about it because it only cost you a couple of pence. And obviously you can then buy these in bulk if you need to. And there's always that option. But I hope this was helpful for you guys, and I hope to see you all in my next video. So the next video, I'm going to probably do something on desert basing. And then once my base and tutorials are all finished, I'll obviously do a few more after that. We're going to probably do something like an urban wasteland one, where I'll do loads of rubble, that kind of stuff, something for 40k. Once I've done them, I'll probably start doing some painting tutorial videos on Necromunda. And then we can pretty much take it from there. So, happy wargaming, guys. I hope you like this video. You know, follow me on social media. I'm on Facebook. I'm on Instagram under Tabletop Painter. Drop me a like. You know, send me some messages and pictures of the bases that you've done using these techniques. I'd love to see your army pictures. That'd be fantastic. And I hope to see you all in the next video. And happy hobbying.